Hello everyone, so in this video I will be showing you some of the simple features and tricks that you can use for your Zoom meeting. So let's get started. So currently have here a sample meeting over here, only two participants there, one is me and another one is my phone. So first feature is the chat feature. So suppose if you have many chats in your that chat box over here and there are some important links or important notes that you want to copy, so what you will do is you will just copy this over here, copy this entire text and just paste it in a Word document or a notepad. So to save your time, what you need to do is you can go through this option, more option over here, just select more and can just give save chat. So as you can see, a chat saved and it will show in a folder. If you just click show in your folder, you will be having a text document that is not our notepad. If you just double click it, you will be seeing all the chats who sent at what timestamp. So for example, demo is my name actually, as you can see here. Demo is my name and I have sent from me, hi, hello, hi, welcome, and this is the on my mobile device and I have sent hi, thanks for watching this video. So it is also present with timestamp. By this way you can save very large amount of time. Suppose if they are sending paras of notes, you can just with a single click save everything. It's a really handy trick. I found just now this trick and I wasted so many time before, so feels bad for that. So anyhow, this is a really cool trick. And another thing is to send some documents. So here also, this is also through the chat. For example, there is an option like this text document like icon. If you just select this thing, you have like the six options where you can send your files. Okay, for example, if I go to your computer and if I want to send some picture, okay, so if I want to say here I have a picture, okay, sample picture, if I just click open, it's sending, it's also sending, just sends the picture to everyone in the chat. So it's just accessible to everyone. Suppose instead of sending to mails, if you need to get the mail ID of everyone, it's just a hectic work. But through the Zoom meeting, it's just a single tap. You can just send all your files to everyone and it's accessible to everyone. And you can also send to privately also. Instead of everyone, you can select the particular person that you want to select and you can just send it to them. So it has features for Dropbox, OneDrive, Google Drive, Box, SharePoint and your PC. So it's just really, really cool feature. And these two are like I have found recently only. So another feature is that recording feature. I hope many of you will be knowing this. Just go here and record this. Press record button and as you can see here, your meeting will be recorded. So whatever displayed in the screen will be recorded by your inbuilt Zoom meeting recorder. So this is a really cool feature because suppose if you really want what you know what happens in the meeting and if at the same time you really want to take rest, it's a really handy feature and you can even revisit your notes. So just stop recording or pause recording and this. Both the things, if you just stop recording, okay, the record will be converted to MD file when the meeting ends. And when you end this meeting, I will show you at the end, okay. If you end this meeting, it will directly take you to the folder where this meeting, where the file has been recorded. So I will show you where this file is recorded at the end. And the next feature is going to be the simple ones. Okay, these are the features for the participants. In case of the host, there are tunnel out of features, okay. Basically, you are going to control the entire meeting. So additional features will be there for the host. The next feature is going to be the audio settings. So this isn't only about the audio settings. It has really like the it's the control panel, like the control panel of your computer. Okay, so it has basically this accessibility. So here it's just a simple things for it's not that important. And here are the keyboard shortcuts. So you can assign keyboard shortcuts. You can use them. These are not set because they are used by like the OS or other applications. So they are not set. So you can also give enable global shortcut. So there are shortcut. And next is the statistics. So this basically tells you how much CPU or RAM occupancy that Zoom is occupying, your Zoom meeting is occupying currently, and it also shows the bandwidth, network type, proxy, and the type of connections. And it also shows the video, okay? Video, it shows the packet loss, resolution, frame per second. I'm not in video mode. And for your screen sharing also, it shows the statistics. This is also a really cool feature. So to tell us about the performance of your computer, okay? And next thing is recording. So as I told you, this is the folder where my recording has been saved. So you can change this anytime, anywhere, and you can also add the timestamp for your recording. So if I just go to this folder, it's in Documents Zoom. So this is that folder actually, Document Zoom, and I have this meeting, and here is that MP4 folder that has been recorded. If I just go here and open with, I will go to just Films and TV to play it. Okay, so whatever is displayed on the screen will be recorded. So in my case, actually nothing got displayed, so okay, this is going to be just going to be recording, okay, over here. So that's really cool. Okay, cool feature in case of recording is concerned. And next is the background and filter. This is for you turn on the video, and if you're a host, you can try this. And next are just basic stuff. Screen sharing, audio, you can test your audio for here, and video is also there. You can put original ratio HD and adjust light like that. Simply set up how you want to display the quality of the video. You can just adjust using this, and this is general, start zoom, and use 12 under sum. These are the basic standard stuff. So these are the cool features that participant can use in Zoom. If you are a host, there's many features. I will also try to tell that about another meeting. And that's it for this video. And my programming channel, do check out my research channel and tutorials in C, C++, Java, Blender, Unity, Python, etc. And kindly check other videos of my channel. And thanks for watching. Subscribe and support me. Thank you.